Hi, I'm Sergeant Todd Mock with the Albuquerque Police Department Open Space Division. And this is our airboat, which we use every day in the open space. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about it, and I'd like to take you out on the water. These are the rudders. We check for freedom of movement, make sure they're not dented. But these are tabs that help keep the wind coming off them so that if they need to make a slight adjustment, if it's overcompensating to the right or left. So you can see that they're fairly lightweight, and there's connected to a rudder control up in the front, and that's how we control the direction of the boat. So we check the overall just condition of the engine, make sure it's not coming apart. We look to make sure all the grease fittings that looks like they've been filled. We check the top, because anything that can come off or interfere with the propeller can damage it. We'll check the front component of it. It has two batteries, has a really good alternator. It charges itself fairly rapidly. It holds anywhere from 5 to 7 people comfortably. We like to operate with anywhere from 3 to 4 as our normal standard crew. These are the seats and everything else. It's pretty standard. Right here by my foot, this is a control panel. Power for the engine itself. You can see it's just like a regular gas pedal. You push on it and that controls our speed. Yeah, this is the rudder control. Controls our steering. And actually all we do is check the freedom of movement, make sure it's not binding, and that it seems to go from full right to full left. Okay, this up here is our forward deck, and it's actually used to observe off it. The other thing is this is a brush rail, the forward part of the boat when you're driving along, in case you go over, like in Florida, the Everglades, they have the very tall grass. This is used to knock that grass down. We use it a lot in just maneuvering across or around sandbars. In the event of an emergency, we'll be notified by dispatch that there's a situation on the water itself. And we do store this in the Valley Area Command or at the biopark. Once we do receive notification that this some type of assistance is needed, we will deploy the boat, and it takes approximately 15 minutes to get it on the water. There's one of the many transient camps that we come across while we're patrolling the Bosque. Because they're so along the shoreline, sometimes the accessibleness of the camp itself is hard to get to. So therefore we use this to go identify camps and then help the people at either one, try and get them somewhere else to stay, or two, at least get them out of the park so that the decreases the fire danger and also the health risk.
Our patrol area starts at the Rio Puerco, and it actually goes up to the base of the Petroglyphs, which is the national park. And then we resume in the Bosque area, which includes the state park, from Sandia Pueblo down to Isleta Pueblo. And then we do all the open spaces at the edge of the Sandia, part of the Manzanos. And then we're responsible for additional 4,000 acres in the East Mountains, which includes Oak Flats, Juan Thomas, and the Golden Area. So